Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. Today we will learn about capacitors. Capacitors are one of the basic components most commonly used in electronic circuits. What is a capacitor? A capacitor is a passive electrical component which has the ability to store energy in the form of an electrical charge. These are the commonly used capacitor symbols. Capacitor stores electrical energy just like a battery. But they work in completely different ways. Inside a battery, chemical reaction produces electrons. A capacitor can't produce new electrons. It stores electrical energy in electrostatic field. Capacitor stores less energy as compared to the battery. And it can charge and discharge much faster than battery. Let's see how does a capacitor works. Just imagine that water filling into a tank. The tank can store some water. If you open the tap at the bottom, the water will flow out of the tap. Now, if we stop storing the water into the tank, we still get water flow out of the tap until the tank empties. Once the tank fills again, we will get water flow out of the tap. We can start or stop filling the tank as many times as we want. As long as we do not completely empty the tank, we will get flow of water from the tap. So here we have used the water tank to store water to smooth out the interruptions of the supply of water. In an electric circuit, the capacitor acts just like a storage tank to store energy. It will charge and discharge to smooth out the interruptions of the supply. Let's take an example of a simple circuit without a capacitor. If you turn on and off switch very fast to simulate interruptions, the light will flash. But if you connect a capacitor into the circuit, then the light will remains on during the interruptions as long as there is charge in the capacitor. Because the capacitor discharging and powering the circuit, the capacitor will charges and discharges to smooth out the interruptions of the supply. Capacitors are manufactured in various types and shapes. The internal structure of a capacitor looks like this. It consists of two parallel conductive plates separated by some distance. The space between the conductors filled with insulating medium called dielectric. Many capacitors got their names from the type of dielectric medium used inside it. For example, paper capacitor, ceramic capacitor and etc. Some capacitors like electrolytic capacitors are polarized. They must be connected in the circuit according to the marking on the case. Initially, the positive and negative charges on the two plates are equal. The negative charge is because of electrons and the positive charge is by depletion of electrons. When an external supply is applied to the capacitor, the positive potential of the supply attracts the electrons from the plate connected to it, making it positive. While the negative potential of the supply forces the electrons to the other plate, making it negative. Hence, the potential difference will be established between two plates. This is called charging of a capacitor. The momentary flow of electrons from one plate to other through the supply, but not through dielectric, which is an insulator. The capacitor stops charging when the voltage across the capacitor equals to the supply voltage. The time span is called charging time of the capacitor. If we increase the supply voltage, the more charge can be forced into the capacitor. When the battery is removed from the capacitor, the two plates hold the charge or potential difference for a certain time. It is because of positive and negative charges on each of these plates attracts each other. But because of dielectric between them, they never can reach each other. The charge will stuck on the plates. This creates an electric field between them. The strength of the electric field is given by the expression voltage divided by distance between the plates. E equals to V by D, volts per meter. If a path in the circuit is created, like placing a small lamp in the circuit, which allows electrons to flow through by powering it on and to reach the opposite side. This only lasts for a short duration until the electrons on both sides are equal. Then the voltage becomes zero. This time span known as the discharging time of the capacitor. The dielectric is an insulator. It has electrons in the outermost orbit of their atoms. When there is no charge on the plates, the electrons moves in a circular orbit. When the charge deposit takes place, the electrons tends to move towards the positive charged plate. If the charge increases further, the orbits expands more. As the voltage between the plates of a capacitor increases than the specified voltage rating, the dielectric medium comes under increasing stress till it can no longer bear it. At one stage, electric breakdown occurs accompanied by a spark between the two capacitor plates. The maximum voltage per meter thickness which a medium can withstand without a rupture or breakdown is called its dielectric strength. SI unit is volts per meter. On the side of the capacitor, we will find the value of capacitance. It measures the ability of a capacitor to store charge. It defined as the amount of charge required to create a unit potential difference between its plates. Suppose we give few coulombs of charge to the plates of the capacitor and it develops V volts between their plates, then its capacitance C equals to Q by V. Capacitance is measured in farads, represented by letter F. Since farad is too long for practical purposes, hence much smaller units like millifarad, microfarad, nanofarad and picofarad are generally employed. The capacitance of a capacitor means how many farads it has depends on how it is constructed. There are three factors which influence capacitance. First one, area of the plates. Capacitance is directly proportional to the area of its plates. Larger plates provide greater capacity to store electric charge. Therefore, as the area is doubled, the capacitance will also get doubled. On the other hand, capacitance is inversely proportional to the distance between its plates. Electrostatic field between the plates is stronger when the plates are closer together. If the distance between the plates is doubled, the capacitance will become off. How many farads of capacitance a capacitor has is depends on the type of dielectric medium is used. It is called dielectric constant or relative permittivity. Permittivity of a medium describes how much electric flux being generated per unit charge in that medium. Here, relative permittivity ER refers the permittivity of dielectric material in comparison to the permittivity of a vacuum EVO. The relative permittivity of some materials listed in this table. The higher the permittivity, the higher will be the capacitance. So, by combining all these three factors, we get capacitance of a capacitor by this expression. The difference between a capacitor and a battery is that a capacitor can dump its entire charge in a tiny fraction of a second, where a battery takes some time to discharge. That's why electric flash on a camera uses a capacitor. It dumps its full charge into the flash tube almost instantly. Capacitors can also eliminate ripples. If a line carrying DC voltage, for example, rectifier output, has ripples or spikes in it, a capacitor can even out the voltage by absorbing the peaks and filling in the valleys. A capacitor can be used to filter out certain frequency. Low frequency filters and high frequency filters can be designed by using capacitors. That's all about capacitors. If you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. In next video, we will discuss about series and parallel combination of capacitors. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.